Hi, and welcome to a new video of this MOOC. In this video, we are going to see with detail how an Angular component works. But let's first take a look to what is actually an Angular component. An Angular component is a part of the application that controls a patch of the screen called a view. An Angular component is divided in three files, or it's defined by three files. The first one defines the logic of the component and is just a JavaScript class. The second one defines the view and is just an HTML file with several extensions that Angular provides. And the third one is a CSS file that defines the style of the view, of this patch of the screen. The class, the JavaScript class in which we define the logic, interacts with the view through an API of properties and methods. And Angular self-manages the components, creating, destroying, and updating them dynamically and following the component lifecycle that we will see later with detail. The component metadata is the information we include in the component decorator in order to specify several configuration of the component. As we can see here in this example, we use the selector option in order to set Angular in which HTML selector it has to render this component. Then we have a link to the file in which the template of this component is included, a link also to the file in which the style sheet is included, and also we have a list of providers of this component that are the services the component requires in order to implement the logic. Regarding the logic, as I introduced before, this is just a JavaScript class in which we define a set of properties and methods, and that is connected with the template by bindings. Here we can see, for instance, the logic of this to-do list component, in which we have defined two properties, a constructor, and also two methods of the component. We can see here, this is included in a file with the TypeScript extension. On the other hand, we have the template that is an HTML file. Remember that this is the path we specified in the component metadata. And this file tells Angular how to render the component. As I said before, this HTML file is enriched with several Angular template syntax, for instance, data binding, directives, or pipes. Here we can see, for instance, a pipe that formats the output to an uppercase format. We can see also directives, for instance, this ng4 directive, and we can see also the data binding, for instance, here. We are rendering here the value of the title property that we define in the logic. But don't worry, because we will see this with detail later. If we go to the component styles, this is just a file in which we define using CSS language the style we want to apply to our view, and we can include here in the component metadata the link to the CSS file, but also we can directly include here the defined styles. Of course, we can also use the is CSS and less styles. An Angular component has a fourth file that I didn't mention before that is used for testing the component. As you can see here, we are not going to enter in details of testing in this video, but each component can be individually tested. So this is very useful because we can encapsulate our test in taking into account just components. So here we can see a set of tests that we can perform to our component, and using the Angular command line interface tool, just typing ng test, Angular runs the application in watch mode and launch the karma test running runner in which we can see the results of the test we have defined. Okay. As I also said before, Angular creates, updates, and destroys the components following the lifecycle that call hooks for being able as a developer to act in key moments. In this table, we can see the different hooks that Angular calls when specific moments occur in the lifecycle of a component. For instance, we have ng on init that is executed when the component is initialized. We have after content init that is called when Angular prints external content in the component view. We have a set of Angular hooks that you can check in the documentation if you want to see more details about each of them. In order to use these hooks, we have to implement the interfaces they define in our component class. So for instance, here for implementing the logic of the ng on init class method, we have to include here in the implementation of the class that we are going to implement this interface, and then we can here include the logic we want to execute when Angular initializes this component. The last thing we are going to see in this video is how to manage components using the command line interface tool. So when we are going to create a new component in our application, we have just to execute this command ng generate component and the name of the component we are going to create, and this will create the four files we need for the components: the style file, the HTML file, the testing file, and finally the logic file. Okay. This also, this order, the ng generate component order, also updates the needed parts of the application module of our code. So you can see here how after we create the to-do list component, Angular automatically updates the application module file, importing the component and adding it to the declaration list of this module. Okay, so that's all in this video, and see you in the next one. Bye.